The ATOM Infantry Fighting Vehicle, IFV, was jointly developed by Russian Uralvanzavod and French Renault Trucks Defense Companies. A mock-up of the new IFV was first publicly revealed in 2013. This armored vehicle was proposed for the Russian Army and export customers. Though Russian MOD showed no interest in obtaining this wheeled IFV and went for different armored vehicles instead. In 2016, this armored vehicle was still marketed by Uralvagonzavod, even though European Union and USA imposed sanctions on this company due to Russia's military actions in Ukraine. Also, this vehicle contained a number of Western components. So most likely that the Atom has no future in its original form. The French company provided the VBCI chassis, engine, transmission and fire control system, while the Russian company provided the turret with a main gun and other components. It was planned that a joint French-Russian venture could be formed to produce this IFV in Russia. It was also planned that production version would use more Russian components. This new IFV is rather large. It is even bigger than the Patria AMV. The reason to offer the ATOM IFV in Russia was hard to explain. Considering that recently Russia developed indigenous next-generation Kurganets 25 IFV and Boomerang APC. Unless Russia's own armored vehicles would end up with critical flaws. The ATOM is armed with a powerful 57mm gun, fitted in a two-man turret. It was developed from a Soviet S-60 anti-aircraft gun. Such a powerful weapon is unusual for an IFV. Usually IFVs are armed with 30mm automatic cannons. However, recently there is a trend to upgun the IFVs, as their front armor becomes a hard nut for 30mm cannons. The 57mm gun packs a formidable punch. It can easily defeat all enemy armored vehicles, except main battle tanks. It can be also used to support infantry and destroy fortifications. This powerful weapon also poses threat to ATGM teams. It can also engage UAVs and helicopters. This gun has an effective range of up to 6 kilometers. As it was originally designed as an anti-aircraft weapon, it has a maximum range of up to 16 kilometers. However, engagement range for armored vehicles is typically limited to less than 3 kilometers due to terrain. So the extra long range is not that important. The gun fires at a rate of 120 to 140 rounds per minute. It can fire various types of ammunition and briefly change between these types. A total of 180 to 200 rounds are carried for the main gun. A total of 80 to 100 rounds are ready to use. The other are stored inside the hull. There is also a coaxial 7.62mm machine gun. The ATOM has an all-welded aluminum armor hull with modular add-on composite armor plates. Protection level can be tailored to suit customer and mission requirements. It seems that basic armor provides all-round protection against 14.5mm armor-piercing rounds. Maximum level of protection is against 25mm armor-piercing projectiles. Slat armor can be fitted for protection against RPG rounds. The stated vehicle weight is up to 32 t with add-on armor. Hull has a double floor for protection against mine blasts and improvised explosive devices. It withstands explosions equivalent to 10 kilograms of TNT. Vehicle is also fitted with NBC protection system. The ATOM can carry 11 soldiers, including a crew of 3 and 8 dismounts. Troops enter and leave the vehicle via a rear ramp. Also, there are roof hatches for observation, firing and emergency exit. The Atom is also fitted with a laser warning receiver. It can be also fitted with active protection system. Engine and transmission were provided by Renault Trucks Defense. vehicle is powered by Renault turbocharged diesel engine, developing 600 horsepower. Actually, this engine is owned by the Volvo company. Engine is located at the front. It is mated to an automatic transmission. It is likely that ATOM has a hydropneumatic suspension. It seems that this armored vehicle can switch its configuration from 8x8 to 8x6. While moving on hard surface roads, vehicle is fitted with a central tire inflation system and run flat tires. This IFB is amphibious and is fitted with water jets. However, once fitted with maximum level of protection, it might lose amphibious capability. The ATOM IFV was planned to become a forerunner of the whole family of military vehicles. Based on the same 8x8 chassis, other proposed versions include an armored personnel carrier armed with a 12.7mm machine gun, air defense vehicle, armed with a 57mm gun, 120mm self-propelled gun. Armored ambulance, command post vehicle, recovery vehicle and armored engineer vehicle. However, the future of the Atom is uncertain. European Union and the USA imposed sanctions on the Eurovagonzad company due to Russia's military actions in Ukraine. Also, the Swedish Volvo company, owner of the engine, decided to scrap its involvement in the project. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you like this video and please like and subscribe and put a bell sign to get all the latest videos from my channel. Thank you, good luck everyone. See you in the next video.